Hi, I'm Tara Hitchcock. You are watching Harkins Theaters Behind the Screens. I know you're sitting there in a movie theater. We're actually in the Millennium Falcon, about to punch it. But not yet. We all know how the story ends, but how did it begin? And how did Han meet this guy? Lots of questions answered in Solo, a Star Wars story. And we had a chance to sit down with the whole cast. Punch it, Chewie.
Hey, kid. I'm putting together a crew.
Who are these guys?
Han Solo. Lando Calrissian.
You look good.
You in?
That's yes.
So there are people right now watching this that are sitting in a Harkins theater, possibly about to watch this film. Are they in for a ride?
It's a great adventure story, and that's why I signed on. And there are also, not only does it address the questions, what are the events, what are the relationships that might have shaped young Han Solo, but it does it in ways that are very, I found very satisfying and surprising.
We need to divert auxiliary power to the rear deflector shield.
You've talked about meeting Harrison before this whole project. How important is it that you connect with him after he sees this and find out what he thinks about this?
Well, actually, he has seen it. I haven't talked to him yet, but I know he was very, very enthusiastic about the movie, which has meant a great deal, I think, to me and to everybody else involved, the fact that he was into it, yeah.
Would he tell you if he didn't like your performance?
I don't know. Yeah. Maybe.
Yeah, actually might. So the fact that he's enthusiastic is a good thing.
Yeah, that's right.
Somehow I never get bored with winning. You can't wipe them off. They're holograms.
You also learn a lot about Chewbacca. I learned he's a sore loser.
Hey, Chewie, relax.
Chewbacca is a mercurial dude. You know, I mean, you know, his emotions are right out there in front, and you want to walk on eggshells a little bit around Chewbacca, but he's a good spirit, good soul.
The cape room. I got every cape, okay? I got an everyday cape, sister's wedding cape, intergalactic President's Day cape.
Why don't more people wear capes? Like in this day and age, I feel like you might bring them back.
I mean, I was thinking about that too, wearing them. It's just it's a lot of shoulder. You might take them off and you're still like that. I think that's the problem. It's like, it's harder, but they're so nice. They give a certain sense of, a majestic sense to everything when you walk into a room.
I feel like the cape could replace Spanx for women. Like, you don't even need anything.
God,
you just put a
on
cape
the outside,
on.
Just put a cape around
it. Hides
it. Put it around the top of your head as well. We could just, oh my God, that would be delightful.
Get ready.
There's a lot of Wookiee speak in here. I know it's early, so I hate to do this to
That's
this.
Okay.
I figure it's a warm-up.
Sure.
Give me two words that are actually discernible to you, spoken in...
There aren't any. I mean, there's one. When you see it in the movie, I believe there's a word that gets repeated that was like, I have a plan or something. I think there's a word for plan. And if you link it to the subtitles, you can kind of tell.
And what would that be? God, I don't even know how to do that, seriously. I sound like I'm gargling salt water.
That's not far off. That's pretty... Good.
No, it's not even attractive. Look, I see your
Am
face.
Am I going to do this all day?
Probably. That's why I'm thrilled I'm first. Now I can get out of the way.
It just occurred to me that I'm going to spend...
It's yeah, I'm sorry.
Just meeting
brace
different
yourself.
People and just going... like just sitting across from each other.
So glad we took this job!
Yeah, action-packed. You're a good driver, by the way. If you want to see more with the cast of Solo, a Star Wars story, oh, and we get lessons in how to talk like a Wookiee. Just go to Harkins.com for my extended cast interviews. In the meantime, where are we going? Can you say we need more Harkins popcorn? I understand him.